Hello everyone, thanks for joining me in the Allan Block workshop to learn about what it takes to successfully construct your Allan Block retaining wall project. What I will walk you through today is how to build an inside corner as a part of your retaining wall. Now we always recommend curves over corners, but if the site conditions require it, we have steps you can take to successfully build walls using corners. Now refer to our other videos on how to install a proper base trench and base course, as these steps will apply. So, let's check out the layout here in the workshop to show you how it's done. For our example today, I only will be showing the placement of how to build an inside corner using AB Classic blocks in our workshop. I won't be showing backfilling in this first part, but I will bring in geogrid placement. Before we start, and so you are aware, one of the top lips on each course will need to be marked and removed to construct an inside corner properly. For complete installation details, see our installation manuals on allanblock.com. What I have here is two AB Classic blocks laid out to create a 90-degree corner. I have marked the area that will need to be removed to accommodate the next course stacking on top. Let's head outside and using a saw with a diamond blade or chisel, we will remove this raised lip from the block to form a smooth, level surface. Once complete, we will set it perpendicular to the other AB Classic block. This is the only type of application where we remove the lips from the blocks. Then, using additional blocks, you would build out from the corner for your wall's first course. Make sure to level the blocks in both directions when working on a prepared base. For the next course, you will place an AB Classic block over the block with the lip removed, like this. Then add another full AB Classic block placed to form the corner. You would repeat this layout for each course as needed, alternating the direction of the block with the lip removed. Backfilling and compaction are required, but I am just showing you layout and modifying the blocks. So, what if your wall needs geogrid reinforcement on the first course? When using large wall grid, cut sections of geogrid to the specified lengths for the project. Place the cut edge of the grid, the machine or roll direction, tight against the back of the raised front lip of the block. It needs to extend past the corner by 25% of the total wall height, with it positioned behind the wall in the reinforced zone. Stake down as needed. For the other side of the corner, start the grid against this extended area of grid and against the raised front lips of the blocks and position it in the reinforced zone to reinforce the whole corner area and first course. Continue this process as needed for additional courses by alternating the grid direction. When using large commercial rolled geogrid as I have shown, make sure you are aware of the proper strength direction of the grid you are using. Contact your material supplier for assistance. The strength direction of the grid always goes into the hillside, which is perpendicular to the face of the wall. If installed incorrectly, the grid will only be at about half strength of what is needed. This is the most common mistake during installation. So the next thing I will show here in the workshop is capping. Let's assume the wall is done, grid is installed properly, and this is the top of the wall. To create a cap with a custom finished look, we need to cut two blocks at a 45-degree angle. I can then place the cut caps to finish the corner. Additional caps are then installed down the wall, securing all in place with a flexible concrete adhesive. So, let's recap what we've learned. Inside corners use AB Classic size blocks with one block per course that will need a portion of the front lip removed to allow for placement of the next course. Install the first course out in both directions from the corner. Once the base is laid, level each block and down the wall in both directions. Then, using wall rock, fill the block course behind the block 12 inches and backfill with approved on-site soils. Rake the top of the blocks clean and then compact your base with a mechanical plate compactor a minimum of 2 passes behind the blocks. If you need to use geogrid, it will need to be installed on every other course. When using large commercial roll geogrid, cut it to length and install it from the lip of the block back into the reinforced zone and position to be past the corner by 25% of the wall height. Make sure you are aware of the proper strength direction of the grid you are using. Contact your materials supplier for assistance. The strength direction of the grid always goes into the hillside, which is perpendicular to the face of the wall. If installed incorrectly, the grid will only be at about half strength of what is needed. This is the most common mistake during installation. Then, place the next grid section so it will run perpendicular the other way down the wall. And starting against the extended area of the grid and against the lips of the blocks to reinforce the whole corner area. Install the next course of blocks with two AB Classic blocks creating the corner. One block will again be modified on the opposite side with part of the lip removed. Level each block and down the wall in both directions. Then, using wall rock, fill the block cores, behind the block 12 inches and backfill with approved on-site soils. Rake the top of the blocks clean. Starting on the second course, compact on top of the blocks and then behind the blocks with a mechanical plate compactor, a minimum of 2 passes. GeoGrid will be needed on this next course, just in the reverse direction of the first course. Run it 25% past the corner, then place the next set of grid running perpendicular down the opposite wall. Make sure it is installed in the proper strength direction, which is always into the hillside. Continue this process to the top of the wall with grid on every other course as shown in approved plans. Another grid option is our AB reinforcement grid. This is a biaxial grid for walls on residential job sites up to 6 feet tall that has the same strength in both directions. Biaxial grid allows you to install the grid either parallel or perpendicular to the wall. At the top of the wall, you can use mulch, rock, pavers, or soil to finish, using the raised front lip as an edge. You can also cap your wall with AB capstones. You will need to modify 2 AB caps by cutting them at a 45 degree angle, then placing them on top of the wall at the corner. Install additional caps down the walls, using a high-strength construction adhesive to secure all caps in place. Corner applications and Allan block retaining walls require extra time and skill, which is why it is important to follow these installation steps. If your design requires corners, you know the steps you need to take for a structurally sound cornered wall. Be sure to check out our video on installing curves as an alternative as well. Happy building! Always better! Always Allan Block.